So what they're trying to do is remove all enjoyment from our lives. Now, it's an interesting trick. We should have a think about that. What do we really enjoy? I like going to the gym. I like freedom to go into a shop without worrying about, am I wearing a mask or stuff like that? Or can I go to the gym? Can I go to a swimming pool and swim? Because I like to swim. And I think these are edicts that they believe they can continue forever if we don't say anything about it. At the very beginning of all this nonsense, and I believe that we also have a thing called intuition, and that we all feel an intuition on something. And at the very beginning of this, I was never afraid of a virus. I never felt it. But I was instantly concerned about the government, which is odd, because actually I voted Boris in. Thought he was a good guy. But he's not. Or he's an idiot. Through those whole things, I mean, I would say that I was a libertarian, and that I believe in freedom of choice. That the decision is yours. There is a moral contract that we all stick to, and that we don't go around hurting each other or, calling the police when your sister-in-law comes round or things like that to drop off some clothing. Which happened to me very early on in the crisis. Now, I'm not doing this video to convince someone that what I believe, which is I'm not hugely sure that COVID-19 actually exists anymore, because we've gone way beyond fearing a virus. We're wearing masks apparently. I mean, I don't wear one, so obviously that's totally up to people. If they want to wear one, that's entirely up to them. And I'm not going to stop them. I have a bit of a giggle to myself, I've got to be honest with you. But they totally believe that something with a gauge of 1/10 of a millimeter will stop something that is 1/10,000 of a millimeter entering their mouth or body or expelling from their mouth or body. And people say, oh, why do surgeons wear masks? It's to stop bacteria potentially going into an open wound during that time, and they do change them quite regularly. This is not a bacteria, it's something else, it's nothing. Yeah, can you get nothing through a mask? Don't know, can you? Yes, at the beginning, I was a bit depressed, a bit crazy, a bit mental. But actually, it's about time that we all stop doing all of this nonsense, isn't it? It's not real. It doesn't exist. Okay, I'll tell you what does exist. Our ability to say no. Let's stop this. There's so many reasons why we know that this is false. The PCR test the reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction test. So it can take some genetic material, but between you and I, I am 96% the same as a chimpanzee, but that test cannot determine whether I am a chimpanzee or not. So are we going to trust it? If you knew how it worked, and it was invented to detect lung cancer by Carrie Mullis, and he won the Nobel Peace Prize for genetics, actually, for doing it, then you'd realise that for that job, it's actually pretty good, because what it does is take a bit of material, and then it just amplifies it, copies it over and over and over and over and over again, until you get a result of some kind. And if you're trying to detect cancer in its very early stages, well, that makes sense, doesn't it? But actually, if you're trying to find an infectious disease, which actually cancer isn't, yeah, but also Carrie Mullis, the inventor of the disease, actually said, the inventor of the test actually said, do not use this to detect infectious diseases. Now, why would the inventor of the test say that? We're not making this up. That's something that he said. And that was in response to it being used to detect HIV and AIDS. But it's been used loads of times. It's a con. It's always a con. Social distancing. It's isolation. It's a CIA technique. It's a technique, you know. It really does seem to do a great job of keeping people distanced. The people over the road are scared to death of my children because they think they've got COVID-19, even though kids are always asymptomatic and they can't spread it. They have zero chance of giving it to you. In fact, everybody has zero chance of giving it to you because it doesn't exist. How about that? It is easier to just believe that the government really do have your best interests at heart. But they've been flogging you for years. They've been flogging you like a dead horse. They lend you money that they created out of nothing. And give it, you pay interest on it. And now you don't get any interest on the money that you put into the bank. In fact, I think negative interests are coming in soon, and you'll be paying the bank to put your money in there. The real money that you put in. What are you going to do? When are you going to wake up and go, oh? And the thing is, everybody knows they're just too frightened to stick their head up. That's why. Difference between you and tyranny. So go ahead, ridicule me. Tell me I'm mad. Tell me I'm a nutcase. I'm going to stay believing what I know to be true. This, my heart. Because I know in here the truth. I know the truth in here. And here.